Hello children, this video class is an initiative of Shivjyoti Educational Group. I'm Shavya Vyas and I welcome you all to my social science class. Today we shall be doing the first part of chapter 20, Early Humans. So I request all of you to open your textbook page 120. Open your textbook page 120, okay? So the chapter is chapter 20, Early Humans. The topics covered in this chapter would be the shelter, clothing, food and tools of early humans, then the discovery of fire, the beginning of farming, the domestication of animals and invention of the wheel. So these are the topics covered in this chapter. Let us first start with the first topic, that is shelter and clothing. So what were the shelter of early humans? That is, where did early humans live? Okay? So early humans, they lived in natural caves. Early humans, they lived in natural caves and under large trees. Early humans, they lived in natural caves and under large trees. They didn't have knowledge about building houses then, so they used to live in the open, generally in natural caves or under large trees. Let us now come to the clothes that they used to wear. Early humans, they covered themselves with the skin of animals. They covered themselves with the skin of animals and leaves of trees. That is, early humans, they covered themselves with skin of animals and leaves of trees. Okay, so this is about the shelter and clothing of early humans. Our next topic is tools. Let us now talk about the food that early humans ate. So what was the food that early humans ate? First, they used to eat wild fruits, roots of plants, and three, they used to hunt small animals, and they used to hunt small animals. So these were the different types of food that early humans used to eat. They used to live on wild fruits, roots and flesh of small animals. Okay, but slowly with time they realized that they could use long wooden sticks to pluck wild fruits that were in a height. They realized that they could use sharp stones to dig out roots of trees and plants, and they also started using small tools like sharp stones and wooden sticks to kill small animals. So that's when they started realizing the use of tools, and that's when they started applying the use of tools in their daily lives. So what were the various tools? What were the various tools that they used? First, they used to use stones with sharp edges . Second, they used to use animal horns and bones. Third, they used to use sharp wooden sticks. So these were the various tools that the early humans used. One, stones with sharp edges. Two, animal horns and bones. And three, sharp wooden sticks. Let us now talk about how early humans discovered fire. So the early humans, they first got the idea of fire after seeing natural fires breaking out in the jungle. So by seeing the natural fires breaking out in the jungle, they started realizing the use of fire. First, they were afraid of fire. They themselves were afraid of fire. And slowly, slowly, they understood that this fire could be used to protect themselves from the wild animals, because animals also were afraid of fire. So they used fire to scare the wild animals and keep themselves safe. And after that, they started realizing that by cooking these roots and flesh of wild animals in fire, the food became tastier. The roots started becoming tasty. The raw flesh which they used to eat before, it also started becoming tasty after being cooked in fire. So slowly, slowly, after seeing the natural fires breaking out in the jungles, they realized that they started using fire. So how did early humans use, for what all did early humans use fire? One, to keep away the wild animals. Two, to warm themselves during cold seasons. Cold weather. And three, to cook the raw roots and flesh of animals. Okay, so these were the different ways in which early humans learned to use fire. One, they used fire to keep away the wild animals, that is, they protected themselves using fire. Two, to warm themselves during cold weather. Three, to cook the raw roots and flesh of animals. So these are the different ways in which the early humans learned to use fire. Other than this, once they got the idea of fire from natural fires breaking out in the jungle, they also learned to make fire on their own. So how did they learn to make fire on their own? They learned to make fire by rubbing two stones together by two stones or two or two bamboo sticks together. Okay, so early humans, they learned to make fire by rubbing two stones together or two bamboo sticks together. Let us now talk about the topic, the beginning of farming. Early humans, they used to move from one place to another in search of food, okay? So whenever they used to eat fruits and throw the seeds, they realized that after some time, from these seeds, new plants started growing and they could obtain fruits from these plants. And that time, they got the idea that we can also grow plants here. And instead of moving in search of food from one place to another, they decided they can secluded area where they can sow seeds and grow plants, and thus they won't have to go here and there in search of food. So that's how they started farming. That's how they discovered farming, and because they discovered farming, they now settled in one place instead of moving from one place to another. And once they started learning farming, they realized to start farming, you need water and fertile soil. So they started looking for places near rivers. And once they found rivers, they started forming villages near those rivers. And thus, they started settling down in villages. And once they settled down in villages, they started taming animals. What is taming animals? Taming animals means controlling animals and using them for their own purposes, for various purposes. Okay? So they realized that some animals such as horses, donkeys, cows, buffaloes or dogs, they could be easily tamed when compared to other animals. Like wild animals, they are difficult to tame, but these animals like horses, donkeys, cows, bullocks or dogs, they could be easily tamed. And these animals, they were used for various purposes. So let us now look at the various purposes for which these animals were used by early humans. These animals were used for plowing their farmlands, Two, they were used for food such as milk and meat. Third, they were used for carrying loads. Okay, so what were the various uses of animals? Animals were tamed for plowing their farmlands. For food, they used to obtain milk from these animals, and they used to also cook meat of these animals. And three, for carrying loads. So these were the various purposes of these animals. So children, this concludes the first part of this chapter. We shall start with the copy work, that is, we shall do the definition part of this chapter today. So children, we shall start with the copy work. Please open your copy work. Okay, in the first line, write chapter 20. In the second line, write the early humans. Underline both of these in red and don't forget your red margins. Okay, don't forget your red margins. Then in the next line, write define and underline this also in red. And your first definition is weapons. What are weapons? Weapons are things used to attack or defend. What's the spelling of weapons? W-E-A-P-O-N-S. Okay. Weapons are things used to attack or defend. Let us come to the second definition. Leave a line after the first definition and let's continue with the second definition. Your second definition is invent. What's the spelling of invent? I-N-V-E-N-T, invent. to make something that did not exist before. What is invent? Invent is to make something that did not exist before. So this concludes the copy work also. We shall continue further with the questions in the next class, children. So children, this concludes the first part of this chapter. I hope you understood this chapter clearly. Please go through the textbook along with this explanation. Do the definitions in your copy work and have a great time, children. Thank you all.